Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman on this Wednesday, the 20th of January, and we have right this very moment started a new administration, and the market seems to like it. It's up 212 points at 31,142 in the Dow, all-time high 31,223. But look at this. The S&P, all-time high. Oops, all-time high right here at 3844, up 45 points. Broke out from the 38.26.69 high of the 8th of January. Very nice action, very strong candle so far. We'll see where it ends the day. And we're also looking at the weekly chart breakout in leg E. It's actually above, at this particular point, it's again above the ChapmanWave inside track repellent zone. That's a good sign. One thing we want to look at here is the QQQ. Now, I think part of this is the QQQs are up $6.49 at 322.89. This is that rotation that I was talking about that I think is, in a sense, a handicap for the NASDAQ 100 with the tech sector. But at the same time, when you've got a Netflix that is up just a little today, $73 at 575.20, up 14.5%. Look at this weekly chart. The week of the 10th of July, it hits 575.37, pulls back, and then I bet that's an equal number of bars, but it's within 1 week of it. So let's just do this for 1 second. I got that there. Now I'm going to go right there, new parallel, change the color to green, and look what we get. We get, let's see how this works out. Oh, my, look at that. 1 week late. It's 1 week late to test the 575.37 high of July, which went to the October, the week of the 16th, to 2020 high of 572. You remember that just missed 0.49? And look where we are today. We've broken out. I love the symmetry of this cup. I drew it in once. In fact, I was going to draw it in again, but it was failing. Last week, I said, yeah, it's actually turning into an arch. Remember, we're all about cups and arches here in the ChapmanWave methodology. And lo and behold, we've got the second U-shaped pattern, like a W. And what we're looking at is a break to a new all-time high. And you can see it, peak B. It missed a peak C by $7. And now it's starting leg C in the monthly chart. That, I think, is a big part of what we're seeing helping accommodate this big rally in the NDX 100 trading vehicle, the QQQ. And now what I wanted to do is to show you that the IWM did make a new high, a kind of a struggle to make the high. It went to 215.98, $1.98 above the 215 round number high of 4 days ago, all-time high. And this is kind of important in the sense that I'm going to be able to weigh this left side to the right side, if there starts to be a bit of a pullback here. So excellent, excellent action so far today. Let me just run these again. Gold up $24 at 1864, still within the consolidation. And GDX needed this so badly because it was about to break to the downside in this one-to-one-to extension in the ChapmanWave falling axe, the inverted falling axe from that trend line. So this is a very good bounce. Now, over the next week, if gold is going to consider that the Fed is opening up the purse strings and it's going to create the sort of inflation that's going to help gold has made some kind of a low, maybe not the low, but some kind of a low over the last few days in the 34s, trading right now at 35.84. I'm sorry, in the GDX. I'll tell you the gold right now because the call is waiting. I want to go there. Let's see. 1865, $25 up in gold, Yeah, let's see where it closes. Let's see where it closes Friday, because this weekly chart is going to be important. I'll just do silver quickly. Silver is up at 25.75, up 44 cents. Nice action. Silver's been just consolidating very well for quite some time here. Silver consolidation. The dollar did try to rally. It's kind of down two ticks at 90.48. It's just holding there. As I said, until the dollar starts to trade at 91.78, 92.30, this is just a bounce. I'm just going to treat it as a bounce. Just let me do this quickly. High-grade copper. High-grade copper holding very nicely in the upper range at 3.64, up 0.009. I want you to do this, and then we've got our first caller. 152 on down 31 ticks in the TLT. I'm watching this closely because I don't care what the Fed says. I'm watching the TNX. It works independently sometimes, no matter what people think. Yes, it's made a peak D, and the daily chart, 10.96, up four ticks, that's 1.09. If it starts to run, it can get to 11.32-ish in the next week rather than come down and break under 1060. That's going to be key. So we've got the watching this. It hasn't broken out yet. I'm going to go to our first caller. We've got, is that TJ? Is that what it says, TJ, Nanking Mass? Yes. Hi. How are you?
Yeah, hi, Basil. How are you? Happy New Year to you. And
happy New Year to you.
So there's kind of a lot of questions here, but, you know, with the yields going up and stuff on the bonds and, you know, a new administration here and the Fed, you know, maybe open up the spigot again, and it just seems good action today in the markets. Is the sky just the limit for these markets, or are they – you know, getting somewhat top heavy, and you know, is the rogue wave gonna appear? And you know, what are your thoughts on all that? And then specifically with Freeport Mac Moran, please.
Okay, so let's do this one thing at a time. Once the Fed, I had a great email today saying technicians can do all they want, but you can't fight the Fed, and that's absolutely true. It's one of the reasons why we had fairly tight stops. We have on our short positions because we've got so many long positions. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm not prepared to take a chance. We can always get in if the trend starts to pull back. So I am looking at this, and we got stopped out of our option position, less than a 15% on an option. That's amazing. Less than a 15% loss. I can always go back. I'm not prepared to take a chance right now of being wrong. Because if the tide is rising, you need some other things to tell you that it's going to change the trend. So at this particular point, I still think this is very selective. I'm still somewhat cautious, even though we've taken off some of our protection. But at the same time, I want to see how this plays out for about a week, because we will not. I'll just make it real easy. I'll get to Freeport McMurray in a second. INDU. If the Dow, which is trading at 31,127 right now, if at any point in the next week or so it actually trades under 30,000, we have begun at least a consortium of consolidation. So make it as simple as possible. It's not a big deal. It's what, Well, I'll be back in a moment with TJ. We're going to be back, and we're looking at the Dow up 190. We'll be right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, folks, we're back and we are looking and we're talking about the markets here with TJ and Natick Mass. We're talking about the Dow up 203. So I'm just going to make it as simple as possible. Why? Because if the market is going to pull back, I'm talking about the Dow first. If the Dow is going to pull back, it needs to break this uptrend line, and this uptrend line is just under 30,500. So I'm saying if the Dow closes under 30,000, give you the exact number right now, closes under 30,500 in the next week, we've started a consolidation. If it closes above 31,380, 31,460, that essentially could be considered a recycle to the upside. So those are my parameters to watch, and I hope that helps you. Now, when I'm looking at something like an FCX, which is, I'll do that a little later on with the S&P and the others as we move on through the show. But what I wanted to say
is, you know, Basil, don't even look at that. Just go on. Forget about FCX. I mean, I've been in and out of it, and it's just like looks like it's gotten away. And just from looking at the chart that you're showing here, it's just don't even waste the time. Just go on to something else. I don't know that you wanted to talk about, because I'm just concerned that, you know, that this, if we're in the same sort of thing again, that, you know, every time it pulls back, you've got the Robin Hood gang and the 20.
So let me just do this. Let me just make it easy for you. Number one is the weekly charts in every major index are really strong. That's the reason why I've been saying I want the shorter term, and we've tried to prepare I can't even tell now because I've got so many positions that we've taken something off, and we've got part positions, we've got short term, long term. So we've got more positions than we've ever had on the long, certainly ever had for my newsletter. But on the long side, they're all long except for we had two short positions. One, I still want that short position at this particular time. I want to hold it a little longer. It hasn't gotten to the stop. And the other is that the option, I could have held it. I just wasn't prepared to do it. I would prefer always to take a couple of small losses, because usually the third one is where we make up everything in a big way. So I'm quite prepared to just hold off and not be on the short side. Not only that, Once you've got Yellen, and we've got Helen as a Yellen as a, she's already been around, so that we know very well her thinking, and the thinking is to, she's not afraid to put money out there, and she's really said that that's what she wants to do in terms of helping the market function, having money change hands, having money go to the right sources, having the what's going on with bonds, that's going to be very important as well. So there are things that I'm looking at, but you've got Yellen and you've got Powell, you've got everybody's working towards holding up this market. At a certain point, the market is going to say, you know, you can hold me up as much as you want. I need a breather, and I'm just waiting for that moment. But I think that they're just, unless there's an overhead of bad news, unless this is cloud cover that says, uh-oh, the market is taking whatever the news is badly, I'm just going to say that this is more important. Let me just do something here. I'm not sure whether I got bumped off. That's there. Oh, so I'm just going to do this. If you don't mind, give me a second. T-I. There you are. Okay, so I think I got bumped off in the den, and I don't want to have that happen. So give me one second. I'm just trying to ameliorate.
No. You take as much time as you want. It just seems, you know, and the things that you're saying are the things that I've been thinking about and such whatever. So I just don't, you know, I know we have to just see and play, have the, you know, your methodology play out here and everything else and stuff. But yeah, it just seems like they'll do anything to keep this market up. And I just don't know if the market is just so long the tooth that it sometimes it does.
So that's the attitude that you should have in your thinking that says, hey, I can't go against the tide. The trend is that every pullback has been bought until that changes. And that's why I said, watch that 500 level, 30, what did I say it was? Ryan, let me get back to it to give you the exact number again. I'm going to go right here. Hey, this is, I've changed back to a very quick mouse, and that's a problem because it hits everything on the page. Yeah, so this is the 30,500 level. Watch it. If it goes under that, you can start to think, okay, at least in the short term. And even if there's a pullback, I think it's going to be rotational because you're going to see some sectors that have been they've been lagging. They're going to come on and help when some of the other sectors that have been leading start to pull back. You can even see that a little bit today with the IWM a tad weaker than the S&P. And certainly it is, as far as the, let me just see if I'm back on, yes. And as far as the actual sectors are concerned, the QQQ, I think he's being led by something as powerful as Netflix, but there are a couple of others that are participating. But I think it's getting a little harder in the tech sector to maintain to maintain a constant source of strength as a unified group. It'll be individual stocks now that I think are starting to show tremendous strength and are helping. So
yeah,
keep in mind.
Excuse me, Basil, just before I lose you, the upside target for the recycle, was that 31,350? I just want to make sure I kind of missed that.
Yeah, if it starts to trade and close in the 31,350 area in the Dow, you've kind of raised the base, at least for the short term. You've knocked out to the potential for the shorts, and it'll take a little bit more before you can get that real big reversal. But remember, I think it's going to be news. So keep your, you know, it's how the market, I don't care what the news is. I only care about what the market does with that news. Now, I also have to say, in my notation, I have this as an E, at least for now, in the Dow, but in IWM, I should call it an F/E because the MACD is strong. Stochastic's at 89. On balance, volume's a little weak, but this is still way above the 9-period green moving average. Is this way above the 14-period moving average? And that's the case for all the indices. So we have not got the pullback. So I hope that helps you. And just listen to the show. I'll be giving you that kind of information when I think it's necessary in terms of whether or not I think that there's a turn down, that it's going to gain downside momentum. So far, it hasn't happened. Hope that helps you.
Thank you very much, Basil. You always always make tremendous sense of all the stuff that happens. So keep it up.
Thank you very much. Okay.
All right. Thank you very much, Basil. Bye.
Thank you very much for calling. So let me just do this. I had a question earlier on, and I was going to get to it. Ah, is that the break? Wow, the day is just flying away here. This show is just zipping along. So I'll come back, but I want to... Oh, TRXC. I'll just do this. It's one that popped up in the den. Oh, my, look at it. 368, A, B, C, D. Yeah, this is actually acting quite nicely. It's up 5%. What's the 450 level resistance and $3 support? I'll be right back.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Yes, so let me just do this. In the den, if I haven't answered any of your stock questions, could you just repost? Because I got a couple of other things that I've got going here. Thank you, Steve, for sending me from Nashua, sending me that information about Yahoo Finance that Bloomberg mentioned yesterday happened to coincide with the stock that we own. Nice coincidence, and that I'm not sure whether it helped or not. But anyway, that was the one thing. The next thing is very interesting. Let's see. This is very interesting because it came Yeah, it came yesterday, just as after my show was finished, and I thought, okay, that's a good question. So, hi, Basil, I'm writing to you because I heard on your program today to give your suggestions, and I have one. I'd mentioned anyone giving suggestions, I certainly would like to take them. I've just started a new thing in my opening call newsletter on a weekend. At least for now, it'll be the weekend. I'm doing it all via video. It's just fantastic. It gives me incredible amount of time to do other actually gives me time for the first time in not years, but decades. Because I spend hours and hours on my charts. You know, look, we're looking at a stock. I had a question about it. I'd have to notate, and I have to put in, this is the daily. But before I do the daily, I like to always say, where's the 120? Then I have to do the monthly, and then I do the weekly, then I do the monthly. And I've got to notate, and I've got to check things out, and I've got to see where everything stands. And then I have to actually type it up. I really looked at it, and in 2 seconds, I know my answer. But if I need to make it clear for subscribers as a technique that we're using, we're deploying a technique. You can't just out of thin air say, oh, this is going to happen. You want to explain why. Now I'm able to do it. So it's fantastic. So a question. So that was my question. So I got this. I'm writing to you because so concerning your trin, this is my ChapmanWave trin gauge. And what is the trin gauge? It's just real simple. It's Richard Arms short-term trading index. And I years and years ago when I heard about it, I immediately started to notate it just as something that I follow. And what it said was, if there were levels on the upside or levels on the downside that it achieved, it took me a long time to figure out that if it was on the low side, it meant that the very next session, the Dow would go negative. Well, twice now in the last month or so, it's actually failed, but this is not a real failure in the sense that, oh my goodness, what's happening here? Because if you go back, you'll see that in the past year or two, it's failed very seldom. And on the upside, we've only had one or two failures. So this is a technique. Now, I'd always said, out of all my indexes, all my techniques, all my tools that I've developed over the years, this is the one that I'm not going to discuss privately to give the numbers on the upside and the downside. And there was a reason for it. And I found that years ago, I used to use the VIX index a lot. And then I said to myself, wow, I wonder how long the 11s and 10s and 9s are going to stay as the low. Well, ever since that smash in March, there's just been completely different numbers. So the reason why I didn't want to formulate something that said, oh, these are specifically the numbers in the trin gauge, and I only use it for the numbers. I don't care about Richard Arms index. I don't care anything other than he's developed a formula. I like the formula, and I use it my way. And I don't even remember his way anymore, but it's my way. But I can't give the numbers, and I can't give you the numbers because I'm sure they're going to change. And I don't want to give a number now and say, that's number one. I suspect that the range is going to change at some point. That's number one. And number two, which is even more important, what I'm finding is that when people email me or in the den, they say, oh, I got a low reading or high reading, there are times when we have completely different readings. So all I can say is this, it's mine. It works on my computer. It works with trade stations, numbers. Maybe you get different numbers. So all I can say is just think of it as very low. And anything I would say, just arbitrarily, I'm going to say anything above two says, in within 2 days, the E-mini should have at least a 9 to 11 point rally. And that can even come when the market is shockingly weak. It can come and give you a big surprise by shooting to the upside. And on the downside, it says the Dow, specific to the Dow, should turn negative. We've seen the Dow up 350 points intraday and then slide to negative. So that's the way it works. So I'm just going to say, I know for traders and all that, but you just look at it on your own. Try to figure out a number that coincides with what I'm talking about, and then you'll have your own number. You might have a different platform, and it might take the numbers from a certain time of the day to a certain time in the afternoon, which slightly differs from me. So that's what I said. That was the question I wanted to answer there. Next question was, where did it go? Oh, right here. Next question was, by mistake, I typed in the wrong symbol. What do you think of this? So the symbol was, there we go. The symbol was CHY. CHY turns out to be Calamos, convertible and high income. I think it's convertible and high income fund. For a fund, and it's an income fund, to go from the $5 area, $5.50 area, to 14, to where it is today's high 15, a threefold gain, and it's an income. This is saying to me, don't dismiss the fact that even if the Fed talks about a low interest rate, that at least in the shorter term, you couldn't get some aberration. And this says you're in leg C daily, you could go to a leg D, but the weekly chart, no matter how I count it, is still only in leg C. So that says this income fund, and it's going in the direction of the TNX, the 10-year, but that's all. That's the only relationship. He's saying that it should go higher. So that was interesting. Now, I don't know if I would have bought it if I recognized this leg B up as a screamer back in November, somewhere around the 13 area. Now, I do think it's going higher, but I think now the upside's starting to be limited. So that was interesting. CHY is the symbol, trading at 14.87. It's up 3 cents today. And that's the story. In fact, if you're looking for something that's kind of a steady mover and you actually fancied it, I say, hey, you can hold this, but it's not one of my screamers per se. Once I saw convertible and high income fund, it's just in a different category altogether. Not that it can't work, it's just not the category that we're looking for right now. So let me just do that. Then a question came in. Where did it go? I saw it just a second ago. Oh, there it is. Okay. So ICLN, that sounds so in clone. I think that's ICLN. Oh, wait a minute. This is iShares Global. Oh, this is an energy. Yeah, energy story. Oh, I never finished crude oil. So let me just finish crude oil. Crude oil is. It should make a leg D just above the high income. We spoke about this yesterday, trading at 53.44, up 56 cents. It should go above 53.98, and then we've got to assess how much further. I'll be back in.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks. So we're back. And a couple of things I want you to do. Number one is, let's see. We've got D-Dog in the Den was mentioned. S&P mentioned it. I think that's right. Was that T? It was mentioned. Yeah. So we're looking at trading at 104.72. It's up 563. And it's making the Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone test. If it, and it's in a triangle, a kind of a wedge, or you can call it a flag. If it's able to trade, it's a trading at 104.90. If it's able to trade at 106.70, it should very quickly test the left side of the 11th of January of 107.74. If it does that, it should go even higher. And it's in a big consolidation with a bias at this particular point. The bias is in the middle. It's like a fulcrum at 103, up and down and up and down. But if it's able to break above that, all of a sudden the trading band says, hey, that high that was made at 111.49 on 23rd of December, that's what I'm going for. If I break above that, watch the all-time high at peak D in the daily, sorry, peak D in the weekly and peak D in the monthly chart. That's a test. And then all of it says with this rising trend line, in the next week, if there's a close under 99.50, it's just stuck in the sideways movement. Now, I thought I wanted to do something, and then I forgot about it. Oh, my. And it felt so important at the time. You know, sometimes these things happen. What did I want to do? Because it was relative to exactly where we are right now. All right, it'll come to me. Maybe I'll just check the charts over here. What was that? Oh, that's what I wanted to say. The SMHs, SMH, this is the semiconductor ETF, made an all-time high of 246.79, and now it's in the red. It's down 95 cents. To me, this is going to be a clue, and that's really the logic, if there was, that I was talking about the tech sector per se, that might start to stall very soon, and that other sectors might take its place. But we have to watch it, because when the SMHs start to decline, that's when the general market actually declines, at least the QQQ. So we got to watch that. All-time high of 246.79, trading now 5 points below that, red candle. But it's done that before, and then it follows up the next day with almost a gap up to the upside. I am keeping this as a leg F in the weekly chart and a leg D in the monthly. Now, what are the connotations? The connotations are that having run so far and so hard to the upside that it turns that whole area of the 14-period moving average of 231.74 in the daily to get that green 235.35 to cross negative, there's no way you can do that unless it slides to the 225 area. How do you get to 225? This is going to have to be some kind of bad news, and so far there isn't. So the question is this a Chapman Wave instant restart, and this really is G/C? Or, because the MACD's been running up very nicely with the price, is this going to turn into a peak G? I'm not going to speculate other than to say this is what I would look for, because going short, we haven't done this for a long time, going short the semiconductor index could cost you not just points, but it could deflect from all the other things that are working for you, because it is vicious. Look at these big green, look at these big candles, both up and down, but it's making higher highs and higher lows. So all I can say is that we'll watch this. So to be on a short-term leash, I would say under 233, that's 8 points from here. It's gonna, I don't know what it's gonna take to get there, but under 233, I'll start to watch the semiconductors to say, is the S&P following in the direction of the semiconductors? Is this a sole individual thing? Is it maybe a couple of semis that are just overbought and are just having to pull back now? Or is this something more, is it broader? Is it more focused? That's exactly what we'll be looking for. So I wanted to show the SMHs. I wanted also, and I thought, oh, great, I've got a whole segment to do it. And of course, slipped my mind and I've already moved on. So we'll move on as well. Oh, that's what I wanted to show you. The IYC, look at this. The IYC is the iShares U.S. Consumer Service. Now, I used to have this notated, but what's really important, do you realize that the consumer service, this is an index, this is a sector, has gone without making a peak. That's why I think February is going to be the real tough month. Without making it, probably for snow year as well, from the 37.50 area in March to 71 today, 71.73. This is extraordinary, and the Fed is going to pump money into the overall market. So the money that's going to go in, I think, is going to be more towards having money, more money being spent. And that's the reason why I don't think that you can just make a blatant statement and say, oh no, the put call ratio or the overbought, or you can say whatever you want. But as long as the Fed money is supporting, it means that rallies could fail, but you've got a cushion. And that's the reason why I say how the market responds to bad news, that's that dark news cloud cover sort of umbrella that I have, is going to be very important. Because look, you've just made a new all-time high in the IYC. And if I'm very strict about this, let me just do this off the, like A, B, C, D. You can call this A, B, C, D, E. So it could be E in the weekly, or you could have started a brand new, like many of them did right here, the low that was made in September, the week of September the 25th, peak A, peak B, peak C, and a D. So all the different ways I'm counting this says, hey, watch that weekly. It's getting close to some kind of a pullback. And then you say, wait a minute, the IYC. And once again, I'm going to say this is the iShares U.S. Consumer Service is that stochastic is flat and steady at 96%. It's not pulling back. And yet the daily pull, look at the MACD, the way it pulled back. Look at the way the stochastic's under 80%. Look at the on-balance volume in the daily. Although the blue or gray color right there, relative strength index, is still pretty good at 72%. I'm looking at this and saying, no, it's the 9 above the 14-period moving average. That's what's been so great here. And it's even gone up higher now as we're talking, 71.80. So don't, that's why I wanted to say to our caller, don't in your mind think one thing and then in your deeds do another. Think, try to be consistent and say, oh, I'm thinking one thing, but the market's telling me to go higher, it's going higher, and until it gives the sign that it says it's coming down, stay with the trend. Come on, slide, the trend is your friend, and the Fed is your friend. I'll be back in a moment. That was a pretty simple.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by,
bam!
As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
So, looking at the E-mini, I'm not going to do the notation because while I've been doing the show, of course, I usually try to notate it, but there's been so many questions going on here. So, look, it's in this up channel, and it's using this as a trend line, and it's up 51 at 38.41, and it made a peak D, and I was measuring in the 10-minute chart, that doji peak D at about 11 o'clock, it pulls back to the green 9-period exponential moving average. Look, since it crossed positive way back at about 8 o'clock this morning, the green has expanded over the 14-period moving average, the black line. So here it is, and this is now E going to an F. In the 10-minute chart, the MACD is flattening out, but it's still good, and stochastic's flattening out at 95%, and it's very good. And the unbalanced volumes are a tad overbought, so that says be careful, getting a little bit overbought. So this has just been a consistent move to the upside, and you've got to be impressed with that because, as I say, going to a new administration, you always got some kind of questions about what they're going to do, how they're going to implement it. This is DRIV. A question now, just as I'm going to the finishing my show. Yeah, this is acting well. It's still got that red candle today, all-time high, trading at 27.40. So you know what? I'll do this. I'll put it down. I'll try to get to it tomorrow. DRIV. And another question came up just as I'm about to wrap up. PLTR, that was kind of just stuck in a range. That's still stuck in a range. And that's a quick peak D in a daily chart. I don't like that. Way underneath the previous high, that just says it's kind of stuck, and I've said that for a while. Palantir, technology, software platforms, yeah. So I'm about to hand you over to Steve Rhodes, Then you're going to go to Dave White and then Tom O'Brien. Check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. We had a quick trade today, but I didn't take it because I said it's got to be done before a certain time and it's got to be done at a certain price. It didn't hit that price in that time that I wanted. It's now gone to that price and it's starting to rally a little bit. Doesn't matter. I had the strict rules for my, at least for the trade. You miss it, there'll still be another one. Don't worry about that. So I think we're about to wrap up, and I'm about to say to you, have a wonderful day. It is Wednesday. See you tomorrow, Thursday. And local company. Oh, GT is a local company. All right, very good. So if I miss something, just email me. I'll try to get to it. I thought I got to most of the questions that came my way. Have a wonderful day. See you tomorrow. Stay tuned.